He's a silly snake. He's a silly snake. He's a silly snake. He's such a silly snake. Silly snake.
Silly snake.
Slithers across the sand.
Across the sand.
He doesn't need any feet.
He's got no feet.
He doesn't need any hands.
He's got no hands.
Sometimes he's squiggly.
Like a spaghetti.
Sometimes he's straight.
Like a pencil.
He's a silly snake. Snake. He's got a forked tongue.
He's got a forked tongue
that helps him to smell.
It's an extra sense.
His eyes are always open.
His eyes are always open.
And he can see very well.
No, he can't see well.
He can't tell when he's sleeping.
Is he sleeping?
Can't tell when he's awake.
Is he awake?
He's a silly snake. He's a silly snake. He's a silly snake. He's such a silly snake.
Did you know that there are more than 3,000 species of snake on the planet, and they're found everywhere except Antarctica, Iceland, Ireland, Greenland, and New Zealand? About 600 species are venomous, and only about 200, which is 7%, are able to kill or significantly wound a human. Nearly all snakes eat their food whole, and sometimes in astoundingly large portions. Almost all snakes are covered in scales, and as reptiles, they're cold-blooded, which means they need to regulate their own body temperatures. Scales serve several purposes. They can trap moisture in hot climates, and they reduce friction as the snake moves. Snakes also have forked tongues, which they flick out in different directions to smell their surroundings. That lets them know when there's danger or food is nearby. Snakes have several other ways to detect a snack. Openings called pit holes in the front of their eyes sense the heat given off by warm-blooded prey. Snakes can eat up to 3 times bigger than their head. Most snakes lay eggs, but some species, like sea snakes, give birth to live young. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed learning about snakes. We're going to draw our own snake picture with oil pastels and chalk on black paper. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to have a look at my whiteboard and we're going to practice this together. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put my page as a portrait. And then I'm going to draw 2 lines going down the center of my page. And those 2 lines are going to be the trunk of my tree. I'm going to draw in the background some leaves and some twigs. But the main focal point will be my main branch. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a squiggly line like what I've done now, and that's going to be the base of my snake. Now this is a bit tricky because we need to make our snake 3D, which means we need to add another little line. So what we're going to do is I curved my line around there to make another line, and because the snake's going behind the tree, there are going to be some portions which you won't be able to see. So if you have a look at where I'm erasing my tree now, that means that the snake is in front of the tree. And so if we erase some parts of that trunk, we can make our snake 3D by erasing those parts. Can you see my snake now? Now it looks like it's wrapped around the tree. So that's what we're going to be doing together. We're going to be creating our little snake, wrapping ourselves around the tree. We're going to add some leaves. We're going to add some different details, whatever details you'd like on the snake. And then we're going to color it in. So let's move on to our black piece of paper and we can redo these instructions. Okay, so step number one is we need to draw the tree that the snake is going to be crawling up on. So I'm going to draw 1 long line from the top of my page all the way down to the bottom, and then I'm going to draw another one. It needs to be quite nice and thick so that our snake has enough chance to wrap itself around it. Then you can draw your branches, and then we're going to move on to our snake. Now our snake is going to start as a squiggly line, so you need to make sure that your squiggles go beyond the sides of the branch. See, I made a mistake there. I didn't make my squiggle far enough, so I need to erase that little bit and I need to pull my squiggle just beyond the branch so that I can make sure it wraps around. Okay, so now I need to make my snake 3D, and how I do that is if I add another line to create thickness in my snake. So as I'm going down, I'm making sure that I'm choosing which lines go behind and which lines go in front. And then all I need to do is erase the lines that go behind, and then I need to make sure that I'm erasing the part where the trunk and the snake shouldn't see the trunk. So if the snake is in front of the trunk, you wouldn't then see that. So I'll help you as much as I can in class to make sure we get this little snake wrapped around our trunk. But it's going to be really exciting when we see it because we're almost creating an illusion with our snake. Okay, so we're going to do the detail on our leaves, we're going to do the detail on our snake, and then we're going to move on to using the oil pastels. Now what I would like you to do is to take the black oil pastel and you are going to outline on top of your pencil. That means that you are going to trace the pencil that is on your piece of paper. You are not going to be coloring in. So when you have outlined your entire snake, we're going to move on to the chalk. And the chalk is lots of fun because you use your fingers and you get to smudge the colors. So choose the colors that you'd like on your snake. And then what you're going to do is that you're going to take your finger and you're going to smudge that color in the section that you would like it to be. So we're going to carry on. We're going to do the branches. We're going to do them brown. We're going to add two different colors in our leaves. And then you can choose a background to finish your picture in. And every time you pop the chalk down, you need to give it a little smudge and then you need to blend it into the paper. After we've done that, you are then going to take your oil pastel and you're going to re-outline your lovely snake. And what will happen is it will give it a lovely outline which will make it pop and you'll be able to see your snake beautifully. Well done, guys. I can't wait to see your lovely snakes.